Now I'm pleased to welcome our Dean of the College of Nursing and Health Sciences, Dr. Yang Tai Wang, to offer a few words. Dr. Wang?
Yes. Thank you, Dr. Haas. Thanks, Dr. Memram, for speaking to us. Good afternoon, everyone. On behalf of the College of Nursing and Health Sciences at UT Tyler, I would like to welcome each of you to this virtual hooding ceremony. For all PhD and DNP graduates, we congratulate you for this notable achievement. I would like to thank the family for your support so that our doctoral students can finish their degrees successfully. I also would like to thank faculty for their outstanding mentorship and thank our staff for their support for all our doctoral students. My charge to you is to move forward with your career with the understanding that you forever represent the college and the university. Please keep us informed and help the college and UT Tyler in the future. Wish you all the best. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Wang, and thank you for joining us this afternoon. I would also like to acknowledge our School of Nursing administrative staff, without whom we would not function. They work tirelessly behind the scenes to support our student success and are integral members of our team. They are the ones who make events like this afternoon happen, and I would be remiss if I didn't give a special shout out to Lindsay Rice, who has worked tirelessly putting these virtual programs together. So thank you, Lindsay. Next, I would like to recognize some extraordinary individuals who have provided guidance and support for these graduates during their time at UT Tyler. These dedicated and caring professionals exemplify the best of the nursing profession. They are our amazing and dedicated faculty. Thank you to all of you who are part of our graduates' journey to get to this day. Now, why a hood? The history of academia regalia goes back to the 12th and 13th centuries. During that time, the first European universities were founded by Catholic clergy, and the academic gown, usually black or brown, signified students' religious status and set them apart from the lay people. The robes were worn for warmth as much as distinction. In addition to the gowns, clerics added capes and hoods to keep them warm during the cold European winters. During the Middle Ages, begging friars used the hood as an alms bag hung around the neck and over the robes. And I know what some of you are thinking, that you probably could have used that to help fund your doctoral education. Don't do that any longer. More often today, our academic robes reflect the color of the university, conferring the degree, and you will see gowns in red, blue, green, or orange. The velvet facing on the doctoral gown is a nod to the linings used by the clerics for warmth nearly 900 years ago. The academic cap or mortarboard is descended from the skull cap worn by the clerics of yore. However, it is the hood that has the greatest degree of symbolism. Most universities follow a dress code established way back in 1897 by the Intercollegiate Bureau of Academic Costume. The code lays out specific rules for style, color, and length of the hood, with doctoral hoods being longer than the master's degree hoods. The border is usually velvet, and the color reflects the discipline in which the degree has been earned. Blue velvet piping indicates a doctoral degree, while a master's hood likely had apricot to reflect a master's degree in nursing. The silk lining of your hood is indicative of the university school colors. That is the reason for the orange and white chevron patterned silk lining on your hood. We will now recognize each Doctor of Nursing graduate individually as they receive their hoods. Here to introduce the Doctor of Nursing practice graduates is our DNP program director, Dr. Sandra Peterson.
Thank you, Barb. The candidates for Doctor of Nursing practice have previously earned baccalaureate and master's degrees. During their years of practice, a passion for advancing the profession of nursing and improving patient outcomes has led these graduates to seek a terminal degree, the Doctor of Nursing Practice, or DNP. As part of that degree, each candidate successfully planned, implemented, evaluated, and defended a capstone project under the guidance of a faculty mentor, industry mentor, and committee member. Nana Ba Ajay. She completed for her project presentation, Team Steps Training. using evidence to impact teamwork in an acute care hospital. I had the distinct honor of being her faculty mentor, and her industry mentor is Dr. Shante Fletcher. Congratulations, Nana. I should say Dr. Nana.
Woohoo!
Yay! All right. Next we have Dr. Barbara R. Chapman, and her project presentation was diabetic foot care in Hispanic females with type 2 diabetes, an evidence-based quality improvement initiative. Her faculty mentor is Dr. Ellen Feinout-Overholt, and her industry mentor, Dr. Virginia Holter. Congratulations, Barbara. Dr. Chapman. Next is Dr. Shakisha Davis, and her project presentation is the influence of end-of-life education on stress, anxiety, and attitude of the healthcare profession student. I was honored to be her mentor, and her industry mentor is Dr. Sherry Smith Keys. Congratulations, Shakisha.
Congratulations, Dr. Davis.
Congratulations, Dr. Davis.
Absolutely. Amazing. Okay, and next we have Dr. Gabrielle Davis. Her DNP presentation, changing admission criteria in a vocational nursing program to decrease attrition. I was very honored to be her faculty mentor. Her industry mentor is Ms. Sandra McCrary Marshall. Congratulations, Dr. Davis.
Woo! There you go, Dr. Davis!
Yay!
Good job. Okay. Next, we have Dr. Melissa De Los Santos. Her project presentation was pressure injury prevention patient initiative. And her faculty mentor is Dr. Ellen Feinout-Overholt. Her industry mentors are Nina Almasy and Angelica Perez. Congratulations, Dr. De Los Santos.
Woo! Woo! Yeah. Woo! Go, Melissa.
All right, very good. Next, we have Dr. Sonia M. Grigsby. Her presentation, sedation protocol compliance for improved outcomes in the ICU. Her faculty mentor, Dr. Ellen Feinout-Overholt, and her industry mentor, Dr. Terry Hoffman. Congratulations, Dr. Grigsby.
Yeah. Way to go, Dr. Grigsby!
Yay!
All right, fantastic. Next, we have Dr. Jennifer Hogger, and her project presentation, The Flipped Classroom, an evidence-based course redesign to increase retention rates in a vocational nursing program. I was very honored to be her mentor. Her industry mentor is Ms. Yolanda Hall. Congratulations, Dr. Hogger.
Woo! Hello, Dr. Hogger.
Okay. And next we have Dr. Cindy B. Kelly. Her presentation is building a comprehensive guideline for the treatment of infants with neonatal abstinence syndrome, an evidence-based innovation project. Her faculty mentor, Dr. Ellen Feinout-Overholt, and her industry mentor is Dr. Christina Chan and Dr. Venkat Kakilaya. Congratulations, Dr. Kelly. Okay, and we also have Dr. Rebecca Taylor Shipley. Her project presentation, Improving Caregiver Health Literacy of Pediatric Febrile Illness, a Patient Care Initiative Her faculty mentor, Dr. Ellen Finout-Overholt, and her industry mentor and also faculty at UT Tyler, Dr. Kathleen Helgeson. Congratulations, Dr. Shipley.
Woo!
Woo! All right. And let's see here, let me get to the next piece. At this time, it is my distinct pleasure to introduce my colleague, PhD Program Director, Dr. Jennifer Chilton.
Thank you, Dr. Peterson. The candidates for PhD in nursing have previously earned baccalaureate and master's degrees. They have practiced, served in leadership roles, and educated patients, families, staff, and students. During their years of practice, a spirit of inquiry and a passion for advancing the profession of nursing led these graduates to seek a terminal degree, the PhD in nursing. As part of that degree, each candidate successfully planned, conducted, and defended an original research study for their dissertation under the guidance of their dissertation chair and committee. First, we have Dr. Damon Cottrell. His dissertation is titled Patients' Disclosure of Sexual and Gender Minority Status, a Comparative Multiple Case Study. His chair was Dr. Beth Mastell Smith, and his committee members included Dr. Kathy Miller and Dr. Carmen Cruz. Way to go, Dr.
Woo! Yay, Damon!
Our next student is Dr. Hollis Franco. Her dissertation is titled The Effects of an Online Mindfulness Program on Depression, Anxiety, Stress, and Coping Among Undergraduate Second Year Nursing Students. Her chair was Dr. Danita Alfred, and her committee members included Dr. Jennifer Chilton and Dr. Sarah Sass. Way to go, Hollis. Dr. Franco. Yeah,
congratulations, Woo! Dr. Franco.
Woo! And next, we have Dr. Marissa Jimenez. Dr. Jimenez's dissertation explored motivators and barriers associated with intent to complete a BSN for Hispanic associate degree nurses. Her chair was Dr. Jennifer Chilton, and her committee members included Dr. Danita Alfred and Dr. Maravik Taragosa.
Woohoo! Yay, Dr. Jimenez!
Congratulations! So at this time, if you would pause and start the hooding, please take pictures and submit them to hashtag UTTDoctoralGrad. Congratulations, everyone.
Yay, Dr. Chapman. Woo!
Once you've all been hooded, Dr. Haas will return for closing remarks.
It looks like everybody is appropriately attired. Those things can be tricky, can't they? Well, congratulations to all of you. We are so proud of you and your accomplishments. And there are several others who would like to express their congratulations to you as well. Your perseverance during this very challenging spring semester has been a tribute to the strength of your character, and we thank you all for joining us this afternoon. We also look forward to seeing you at the on-campus graduation to be held September 12th. You will also be invited to participate in an on-campus hooding ceremony this fall. And we do look forward to hearing from you as you embark on your careers and new roles that will impact countless individuals, families, and communities for years to come. Congratulations to all of you.
Woo! Way to go, everyone! Yay! Woo! Woo! Proud of y'all.
Fabulous.
Great job.
Proud of you too, faculty, all of us, you guys. We hung in there.
We all made it through together.
Yeah, we did. Absolutely.
Especially this challenging semester.
Exactly.
So proud of you, Keisha.
Great job.
Where is everybody? Oh, neat.
Oh.
It's so fun to see the families.
Yeah.
That's very cool.
Hey, families.
Come on back.
Come on back.
Oh, hey, y'all.
Great job. Congratulations.
Yay.
Big thank you to all the families.
Yes.
Love the four-legged ones too.
Yeah. Yes.
The fur families, yes, absolutely.
I have been taking pictures, so.
Dr. Chapman, you've got a good picture there. You got a lot of people crowded in.
Wow.
Dr.
Davis,
no.
All her
family.
She's
got a family in there, too. That's great.
That's great.
Way to
go, Dr. Chapman. Woohoo!
Woohoo! Yeah.
That was the end of our very brief ceremony, but I'm going to leave the Zoom going so you can chat and visit for a bit. We sure do miss seeing you, and I'm so sorry.
Oh, we do.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Man.
Virtual hugs to everybody.
Yes. Absolutely.
Big hugs. Big hugs.
And if you don't live in Tyler, anytime you're passing through, we expect you to stop by and say hi.
From the students' perspective, did you guys enjoy this? We hope it met. How's this feel for y'all?
Amazing. I'm crying over here, so thank you.
You are welcome. We cried looking at y'all. So proud of you, Hollis. So
thank y'all for everything. Y'all are amazing. Very amazing faculty. Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
Yeah. Great job.
And thank you for some of our graduates who are here. I've noticed a couple of those, plus some of the students who are following behind you that you are inspiring.
Yes, absolutely. That's very true.
And I see Marissa's daughter. Can you introduce her? I've heard about her for years. She's beautiful.
Hi, how is everyone? This is Larissa.
Oh, how sweet. Hi there.
An inspiring nurse.
That's right.
Yes, yay.
Your mama talks about you all the time. She really does.
Fabulous.
And I just wanted to thank you all as well. I mean, this was really nice. I got more emotional than I thought I was going to get. I shared this with my mom and my siblings, and so it was really nice for you all to do this. It meant a lot. And thank you to all the wonderful faculty and staff, and it was an excellent experience. I loved my years at UT Tyler.
Yay.
Well, you're not done with us.
No.
I'll be there, and they'll be here. My husband and my daughter will be there with me as well. So. We'll
okay.
Great.
And how old is your daughter, Marissa?
11.
So we expect to see you applying to UT Tyler in about 7 years?
Yep.
Yay! And Gabrielle, I love your background. Some nice decorating there.
Yes,
I know, super right? Fun. That's amazing.
It doesn't look like you're in the RV.
No, we came to Houston. So today we're allowed to, run free. So we ran to Houston. This is my son, Griffin.
Hi, Griffin.
Hey.
My daughter, Lindsay.
Hi, Lindsay.
My wonderful wonderful husband, Scott.
Woohoo!
Corey, who's a BSN in labor and delivery.
She knows about our BSN to PhD program, right?
Oh, and this is my we're all a very close family to you. This is wonderful, you guys.
Yes.
Awesome.
I like the Dr. Mom.
Yes.
I figured out what it was.
And Dr. Parker, we have a cat in the frame just for you.
Yes.
Good, yeah. Mine's here celebrating too.
Yeah, mine's still on the floor.
Gabrielle, I feel like your cat is actually graduating today as well.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, we've seen a lot of her cat over the years. Certain parts of her cat.
Thank you guys for doing this. Yeah, it means so much. Really appreciate it.
And Keisha, you got like the whole family there, girl.
I do. Thank you. Yes.
Thank you. Yes.
That's awesome. It's great to see everyone.
Very nice.
Yeah, Don, it was good to see your family as well. And you too, Jennifer. And Cindy. Oh,
Cindy.
That wouldn't be your mom,
Cindy's
would it
mom?
Be Cindy? I mean,
you're
don't
Cindy's
look anything
mom.
Alike.
Yeah, they do look alike.
Not a thing.
Yeah.
I'll be honest, it was weird to see Sonia not at work.
Sonia's at work.
She's at work.
Okay. I saw your shirt, but the background didn't look like your normal background.
I had to come.
Yes.
All right.
The good thing about Zoom is you can attend from pretty much anywhere.
Mm-hmm. Nana, you look great.
Thank you.
Jennifer, you did it, girl. After
Yay.
All the journey.
Tell me about it. My son.
Oh, look at your whole family.
Aww. Oh, and look at there's Nana's family. Hi, kids.
Very sweet.
Dr. Parker, my son said, oh, is that Dr. Parker? That's him. Dr. Parker.
Hi there. Hi. Had fun working with your mom.
There's Jennifer with son.
Yes.
Son. Yay.
And husband.
Yay.
They're all a little camera shy.
Oh.
Oh, there they come.
Yes.
We just found out Dr.
Shipley. Everybody.
Dr. Shipley, unfortunately, is on the front line, so she's not able to be here. But thank you for letting us know, Dr. EFO.
Yeah.
We can all send her a message to tell her congratulations. So.
Well, and Lindsay gets pictures posted very quickly, so I suspect that, and if you all upload yours to that hashtag, then she'll help incorporate, help you share those as well.
How do you take a picture?
This was the perfect ending to our series of virtual hoodings and pinnings, starting last night, this morning, and now this afternoon. This was the perfect ending, so.
Yes.
And ending for you, terminal degrees, how about that? Unless you decide to get a PhD or a doctorate in something else.
Yes. Do a postdoc.
Do a postdoc, yes.
Or be like Sonia and come back for a postmaster's program.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
She's currently in our postmaster's FNP, correct? Dr. Grisby? Yeah.
It never stops.
Mm-hmm. Well, if everybody's done with their goodbyes, their hellos, I will end the meeting.
Bye,
everybody.
Bye.
Love y'all.
Thank you.
Take care of yourselves.
Sleep.
Stay safe, stay healthy.